many populations of caribou in British Columbia and Canada are in decline. The chase herd is considered to be part of the southern mountain population of caribou and is listed on Schedule 1 of the Federal Species at Risk Act as threatened. The cause of these declines is often attributed to large-scale habitat changes that alter predator-prey relationships and increase predation risk for caribou. In the last decade, the range of the chase caribou herd has undergone significant change. This change includes the mountain pine beetle infestation, which caused the mortality of lodgepole pine across the province. Following that, the large-scale pine salvage and road building to support the harvest. This is in addition to mining and exploration activities and three large wildfires that burned more than 93,000 hectares of the chase herd range in 2014.
As a result, the population is slowly declining. In response to this decline, Tsay, Dene Nation and Chu Cho Environmental initiated the Chase Caribou Road Restoration Program. We are working to restore roadways to reduce habitat fragmentation and to limit predator access into high elevation caribou habitat.
I'm Sean Rapai, I work for Chu Cho Environmental, and I'm a restoration ecologist. Currently, we are working to restore three roads within the Chase Caribou Range that are all located near Johansson Lake. This group of old forest roads provide access into a massive, road-free area that extends east to the Swan Elle River drainage. The area of intact habitat to the east and north of this road network is more than 2 million hectares in size. In a province full of wilderness, this is truly some of the most remote area in all of British Columbia.
My name is Arshad Khan, and I work for Chu Cho Environmental. Our project team has been working to implement road restoration treatments that will increase site diversity and reduce the impacts these linear features have on the habitat. The first step in restoration work is identifying the feature to restore and ensuring it is a good candidate for restoration. Once a road has been identified, crews collect field data in order to develop a restoration prescription. This involves collecting information about the length and the width of the road, the surrounding vegetation and forest stand structure, riparian features which the road crosses, any evidence of human use, and any associated wildlife values such as winter ranges and identified migration corridors. This information is used to draft a restoration prescription, which identifies the site, its known wildlife values, and the proposed restoration treatments. The treatments we've used so far include mechanical site preparation, slash rollback, tree felling, and access control. Mechanical site preparation involves ripping up the road surface using an excavator equipped with a bucket or ripper tooth. This loosens the compact soil under the road surface and allows water and light in, which in turn alters the soil conditions. This enhances the establishment, growth, and survival of the tree seedlings which we'll plant. Trees are felled and hinged across the road strategically by a certified feller. By felling trees across the road from opposite and alternating directions, we hope to break up the line of sight along the road by providing a visual barrier. While habitat alteration is the underlying cause of caribou decline, it is still important that we attempt to reduce the number of interactions that a caribou might have with a predator along the section of restored road. At the very end, we implement access control, which includes excavating deep horizontal ditches across the road and the strategic placement of large woody debris and logs. The access control prevents ATVs and other vehicles from traveling along the road and allows the planted trees to establish and grow.
Lastly, in areas where the soil ripping treatment was applied, we planted lodgepole pine and scrub birch seedlings. Both these species are common in the area and found adjacent to the old road. The soil ripping is a prerequisite to planting seedlings and enhances their survival. The ecological restoration techniques, which include soil ripping and tree planting, work to accelerate the return of the road to a mature forest environment. Ongoing monitoring of the restored roadway is important, and wildlife cameras are set up to monitor wildlife and human use. Data is collected prior to and after restoration treatments are applied. This helps to evaluate the effectiveness of the restoration treatments applied and whether they achieve the intended outcome. We can then answer questions about how wildlife, caribou, and their predators in particular, are using the road before and after restoration. It can also help to evaluate the establishment and growth of both planted and regenerating tree seedlings. Monitoring will tell us how effective our treatments were at reducing human use of the road. This is important, as continued use of the road by people can in itself limit the regeneration of trees and woody shrubs. Roads and other linear features are a source of ecosystem degradation and contribute to habitat fragmentation and habitat loss. Habitat restoration is just one strategy for stopping the decline of caribou populations in British Columbia. While restoration is always an option, the most cost-effective means of protecting caribou is to protect their habitat from further degradation before it's lost.